Good day, my dear students. You are welcome to marketing class SS1. Our topic today is advertising. Advertising. After a firm must have produced the goods, the next thing is to fix the price. After fixing the price, then how do you get the goods known to the people? Is by advertising. If you check your notes, I gave you many definitions for advertising, but I just picked the one on the board now, which says it can be defined as any paid form of non-personal communication, which is directed, to the customers or target audience through various media in order to present and promote products, services, and ideas. Now, going through this one on the board, you see that when you are making your goods known to people, it is to the customers who are there to buy your goods, and to target audience. Those who are targeting must be known. For example, now, if you have produced Pampers, Pampers is not for the elders, it's meant for the younger ones. So any goods produced has target audience, which you are targeting. So when you are making your goods known, you have certain people whom you are promoting the goods to. Then if you check here also, it is used to create awareness for a particular product, and it will be paid for by a sponsor. So when goods are advertised, you are trying to create awareness to make the goods known to people, so that once the goods are known, they can start buying. So when goods are advertised, the main purpose of doing that is to create awareness to people. So that is advertising defined for you. Now, we have features of advertising. Features of advertising. One, it must be paid for. Somebody has to pay for it, because all those goods you are seeing on your TV, the billboards on the streets, somebody must have paid for them. So you can't just place your goods on the TV and it will be shown. It must be paid for. Number two, its essence is to communicate. Communication is very essential in advertising. When goods are advertised, you are trying to communicate to your target audience. That's number two. Number three, it must have business transaction motive. Any goods advertised is for business oriented. So when goods are advertised, you are trying to make your business known to people. Number four, it is non-personal. Advertising goods is not personal. You are personal when you are doing that. You are looking for a target audience. Like I said earlier, and when you prepare and when a firm in that produces a Pampers, they have their target audience. Their audience in this case are the younger ones, the small children. So Pampers are for younger ones. So any goods advertised as target audience, which the goods are meant for. Number five there, it is directed towards increasing the sales of the business. When you are advertising your goods, you are trying to make to make profit. Then how do you make profit? It's by increasing your sales. When sales are increased, you are bound to have more profit for your business. Number six, the payee, that is the sponsor, must be identified. The person making the advertisement must be known. You must be able to identify who is promoting, who is advertising the goods. The person doing that must be known and then must be identified. Number seven, it must be produced by a practitioner. We have a body which are known, which is known for advertising. So when you want to when you want to promote your goods, you must go through this body. The body will now take your products and do it for you. That is, make it known. Make it known to the people, to the target audience. Then the last one there, it is persuasive in intent. It must have intention. The intention of your product is to satisfy your target audience. So in doing that, you must be ready to meet your target audience. That's on features of advertising. Now, let's now go to the functions of advertising. Functions of advertising. One, it serves as a medium of attracting the attention of the target public. That is, when you are producing, when goods are advertised, I said earlier, you have your target audience. The goods must have people who are targeted for. Not all goods are for people, but you have your main people, you have your target audience. So in that case now, the goods must be focused on those you want, whom the goods are meant for. Number two, it informs the public about the existence of a product. The public are hereby informed of your product. Without advertising, the public cannot know your product. But when goods are advertised, the product is now well known. Number three, it educates the public about the benefits of a product. The benefits to be derived in a product are well spelled out in advertising. It informs the public about the existence of a product. Number four, it educates the public about the benefits of a product. Number five, it promotes the good image of the organization. By making your goods known, you are trying to create an image for your product. So in that case, it gives the firm a good name. Number six, it builds brand preference. Number seven there, it entertains the public in its presentation and packaging. When you are advertising, you are bound to put in some musical items so as to entertain the public. In doing that, you are trying to arouse the public, their awareness of your product. Number seven, it creates jobs for many people and other skilled personnel. Like I said, there's a body known as advertising agency. That's their own job. So any people in that section has a job created for them. So in that case now, those people working as an agent of advertising, it creates job for the department. Number seven, it builds their confidence and conviction to influence their buying behavior. Number eight, it builds their interest in the message it presents. Like I said earlier, when you are advertising, you are trying to pass a message to a certain audience, that is targeted audience. So in that case now, you are trying to pass a message to the audience. Okay, to the audience. Number nine, it makes them to take action by buying the product. Once the product is well known, then people may start buying the products. Number ten, it increases the market companies, the market of the company product, and helps the salesman to win customers easily. When goods are well advertised, you are bound to have customers. Then, in that case, now the agency for advertising, they are well qualified people. So, when they are doing their job, they know how to get the goods known to the people. Number 12, new prices, terms of distribution, or in the product are made to the public through advertising. In case there's a new price for a product, advertising is the main medium with which in which you can create, in which you can tell the people of the new price. By doing that, a new price can be introduced when advertising your product. And the last one there, it increases the first turnover and also profit. Turnover in this case means sales. When goods are well advertised, the firm is bound to have more profit. So you have there the functions of advertising. So let's now quickly go to advantages of advertising. Advantages of advertising. One, the cost per unit of a product will be reduced. When goods are well advertised, the cost per unit of a product will be reduced. Number two, it creates jobs for people working in the agency. Number three, advertising increases the profit of an organization. Then number four there is the firm also gain in terms of revenue. Like I said, if you look at the advantages here and functions, they are similar, but in some instances, they differ. Like, okay. Like number five here, it says, it helps in improving the quality of the goods. When goods are well advertised, the quality also must be of good standard. You can't just start making your goods known without having goods of high quality. Then also, let's look at the merits of advertising. The merits. One, it encourages buyers. It can encourage too many brand names. It is wasteful in terms of resources. At times, At times now, when you are advertising your goods, you are wasting money at times, because in doing that, the cost of advertising will be placed on the price of the goods. Then, number two there, it encourages buyers to make purchases not necessary. At times, when goods are advertised, you can buy what you may not even need at times. Then, number three there says, the high cost of advertising is passed onto the consumers in form of higher prices of products. The cost of advertising at times will be placed on the price of the goods. So in that case now, the cost of the price of the products will be too high for the buyers to buy at times. So let me stop here for today. We meet next time. Thank you and God bless you.